Well, tonight, 8 on Your Side investigates a proposed bill that could restrict your rights. It was you, Florida voters, who legalized medical marijuana and restored voting rights to felons. But could that power change? A local lawmaker wants to alter the referendum process.
And now an organization behind the restoration of rights is weighing in on that. Tonight, 8 on Your Side investigative reporter Masa Saidi is looking into the proposal and the possibility of fraud when it comes to this process.
Well, Keith Stacy, that lawmaker, says that he has no evidence of fraud. We are in the process of getting copies of election fraud complaints. But first, the lives. This could change.
This is a totally different society.
Tampa born and raised, in 2013, Valerie Ellis created a special ministry for women in prison. Her introduction to the ladies is always the same.
My name is Valerie Ellis, C477410. That C lets them know I've been there a time or two.
Ellis has an extensive record. These pictures document her time behind bars as she turned her life around, but she says she never felt whole because she couldn't vote.
So it was a sense of reminder for a lifetime, you know, that there was no forgiveness.
That changed in 2018 with the passage of Amendment 4 and the restoration of voting rights. Now State Representative James Grant says he wants to change the referendum process and make it less susceptible to fraud.
Where you give a flawed commission structure that incentivizes bad behavior, you're going to get more bad behavior.
There are some people in our legislature that hate the fact that Amendment 4 passed.
Desmond Meade's Grassroots Florida Rights Restoration Coalition spearheaded Amendment 4. He says it took 4 years, hundreds of volunteers, and a lot of hurdles.
We only have a limited shelf life on petitions.
We asked Meade about some of Representative Grant's proposed changes, like taking away compensation based on the number of petition forms gathered and...
For example, what would be the impact of only allowing a petition circulator to be a Florida resident?
It would have a chilling impact on the Citizens Initiative process.
How difficult would it be to determine the financial impact and put that on the ballot?
What's wrong with that? It's already there.
Meade says the changes take away incentive and complicate the process, one that Valerie says finally gave her a vote and a voice.
And Representative Grant was very open about how he thinks there has been way too many constitutional amendments, and he definitely wants to slow this process down.
Yeah, but the State Department, the Department of State, I should say, they investigate fraud. I mean, if you contacted them, what are they saying about this?
So they basically are going to look into this for me. We have just requested data for the past 2 years. The Department of State does the initial investigation, then they refer it over to prosecutors. So we're not going to know if there's any claims of fraud in this process until we get those complaints.
So more to come.
More to come.
All right. Thank you, Masa. Now, if you have a problem you want Masa to investigate, call 8 on Your Side Helpline, the number 1-800-338-0808.